Hello everybody and welcome back. I'm Brian DeMars for ChannelFireball.com and today we're going to be playing a Legacy League with Blue-Green Infect. Blue-Green Infect is not always thought of as one of the premier decks of Legacy. When you think about Legacy, you tend to think about Miracles and Delver and Lands and decks like that. But all things considered, Blue-Green Infect is one of the powerful decks of the format. It may not be the most popular, but it can really get some work done. There are a lot of people who would say it is one of the better decks in Legacy, in fact. My good friend Max McVitie, who is kind enough to loan me his deck on MTGO to be playing today and share his list with me as well, he plays Infect in pretty much everything, and he does really well with it. It's just a really solid deck that pays you for making some good heads-up Magic plays, and it's a lot of fun to play. Big risk, big reward. A lot of fun. So Let's take a look at this list and see what's going on. On the left, I have the lands laid out into two piles. The first one is sort of the blue-green lands. We have a bunch of fetches, Windswept Heaths, Wooded Foothills that fetch out four Trops and a Forest. There's no Dryad Arbor in this deck. And then the next column are sort of my utility lands. Obviously, Ink Moth Nexus is great because it is an Infect creature, which is very much in keeping with the theme of the Infect deck. And then we have a Pendlehaven, which is great for pumping the Nexus, Blighted Agent, Glistener Elf cards. And we have a Wasteland, which is sort of a weird choice, but we do play a crop rotation that can fetch out our creature lands, Pendlehaven, and Wasteland. And after sideboard, we actually have more crop rotation and some even spicier options. So we'll get to that in a minute. So that's the lands. There's 19 of them. They're great. The next category is going to be the sort of card filtering, card drawing cards. We have four Probes and four Brainstorms. Probe is great because in a deck where you're making high risk, high reward plays, you know, going all in on a Become Immense plus Berserk to win the game, a lot of times you really want to know, does my opponent have a Sword to Plowshares? Does my opponent have a Counterspell? Do they have nothing? Should I go for it? Should I play more conservatively? So, Gitaxian Probe has a ton of utility because it'll allow us to know exactly how our opponent is trying to interact with us when we're trying to execute our pump spells combos on our Infect creatures, which is cool. The deck is kind of tricky to play sometimes, and I will definitely admit that a lot of people call Gitaxian Probe training wheels, you know, whatever, but I want to know what they have, because this deck is hard to play and the decisions are often pretty intense. So if it's training wheels, whatever, I'll ride my bike with some training wheels when I play Infect. Brainstorm, I don't think we need to talk about Brainstorm too much. It is completely bananas Magic card. The value is very real. So Brainstorm, I wouldn't play a deck in Legacy without four of them. I know there are decks that don't. I wouldn't play them. The next category are our sort of creature base. We have four Blighted Agents and four Glistener Elf, which are the best Infect creatures legal in the game of Magic the Gathering, so we play all of them. Then we also have Noble Hierarchs, which is a great mana fixer, great mana accelerator, but also really powerful with Infect creatures. That +1/+1 bonus is, you know, basically double what it would normally be on any other creature, since instead of dealing 20 damage, your opponent is locked in at 10 life. So +1/+1 is actually +2/+2. And when your creatures are getting +2/+2 for Exalted, it's pretty insane. Crop Rotation is just kind of a good utility tutor card. It is another Infect creature since it can always get an Ink Moth Nexus, but it has the added utility of the Wasteland and Pendlehaven that we talked about before. It's also, plays come up where your opponent tries to Wasteland your land and you can just sort of cycle out the crop rotation, cycle the land out they're trying to Wasteland with a crop rotation to go get a different land. So that's kind of cool. Can also be a tutor effect to trade out a land under Blood Moon to go get your basic forest, which comes up every once in a while when you play against Blood Moon decks. The next category is our permission. This deck actually plays a lot of permission, but it's mostly sort of protective counter spells. A lot of times you're trying to force through, you know, your lethal pump spells or protect your creatures from Swords to Plowshares, Terminus, Lightning Bolt, removal spells that your opponent's trying to kill your creatures with. So these are kind of nimble counter spells. They're very cheap, very efficient, and they're set up to set up. They're there to set up these scenarios where you're just trying to get under your opponent for like exactly one turn to win the game. You know, you're going to fight this counter spell battle, and you're going to be able to have two, maybe three counter spells going on. You know, just get them, end the game right on the spot. So, three Force of Wills, 4 days, 2 Spell Pierce, and a Flusterstorm. I don't know exactly why Max chose those numbers. It makes a lot of sense to me. I mean, they're all good cards. He's got some versatility. They do kind of different things. You're not going to draw too many that are going to be dead or not useful. So, I'm going to trust him on this one. It's been pretty good so far. And then the last column, these are our pump spells. There's a mix. There's 4 Invigorate. Invigorate, by far the best one, since it's just free, and the drawback of having your opponent gain 3 life is completely irrelevant, since you're killing them with Infect. Free plus 4 plus 4 is a pretty big deal. Then we have Become Immense. We have 2 of those, the Delve Become Immense of Modern Infect fame. We got 2 of those, plus 6 plus 6, a lot of damage. That's almost all the way there when you're infecting somebody. We have 2 Vines of Vastwood, which is sort of a pseudo counterspell plus pump spell. It's pretty flexible. It's a little mana intensive to get the plus 4 plus 4 out of it, but we have enough other pump spells that most of the time we're going to use it to protect our creature from a Swords to Plowshares or something. But it does come up that you can sort of fire it off, get the plus 4 plus 4, and end the game on the spot. And then last but not least, probably the most exciting one, Berserk. I've been playing Magic for a long time, back, you know, in the days when people actually cast Berserk and Vintage and all that. And it's always a lot of fun to get to just, you know, they block, they think they're maybe safe, Invigorate, Berserk, oh, you're dead. Trample over, that's going to be it for you. So, always cool to get to relive the old glory days with a Berserk. Let's take a quick look at the old sideboard here. We have some more counter spells. We have some more Fluster Storms, which are going to be good against combo decks like Storm in particular, the natural enemy of the Storm deck, the Fluster Storm. We have a Hydro Blast, which is good against, you know, decks with like Bolts and stuff like that. It's also good against, there's like mono red decks sometimes, Blood Moon decks. Hydro Blast is just a pretty great card. Also counters Red Elemental Blast in a pinch, which is kind of cool. We have Submerge, which is good against Tarmogoyf type decks. It moves the Tarmogoyfs and the blockers out of the way for free, which is a pretty big game. This deck really likes to play cards for free. In fact, always does. That's sort of its calling card, as much free stuff as possible. So free removal spell, conditional removal spell, is still going to be pretty great. We have another Force of Will for matchups where we need to stop combo decks and matchups where we need to stop, you know, powerful spells. And we can't rely on conditional counter spells. It's like spells that like need to be stopped. They're very important. We got Force of Will for that. Then we have this little crop rotation package. We have a second crop rotation and a Bajuka Bog, which is going to be good against graveyard decks like Dredge or Loam. So we'll have multiple crop rotations to tutor for our instant speed Bajuka Bog. And then we have a Caracas we can tutor for against Sneak and Show decks or Gristlebrand decks or Reanimator decks. Anything that's going to make a giant legendary creature and try and annoy us. You can instant speed crop rotate for Caracas to get the Merit Lage token off the board, which is something that's come up that's been kind of cool. These are sort of our utility cards. We have a Dismember, which is a good removal spell in matchups where you just sort of need to kill creatures. We have a Corruptor, a nice little shatter effect that's attached to an Infector body, which is cool. We have a Crows and Grip, obviously very good for taking out opposing counterbalances or just people who have Haymaker, Artifacts, and Enchantments. You know, sometimes you play against weird stuff like Mode or Ensnaring Bridge or Knight of Souls Betrayal. It's nice to have an uncounterable answer in your deck to deal with that. We have some Sylvan Libraries for generating card advantage. When you play against a more controlling deck like Miracles, a lot of times all you really want is to be able to just draw a bunch of cards and kind of bury them, make them answer everything one for one. And we have a Seal of Primordium, just another flexible answer to artifacts and enchantments. So that is Legacy Infect. I'm looking forward to playing it. I've played a couple leagues with it so far and done pretty decently. I'm a little bit slow as a Moto player. I'm kind of new to it. So I haven't timed out yet. So we'll see if we can get through this entire league without losing any matches to the clock. The deck is pretty fast, so that sort of works in my favor. I'm excited about that. And, you know, as always, drop me some comments in the forums, the comment sections below. You know, if you see any plays that I could have done differently, or, you know, suggestions about the deck or questions, whatever, I'm happy to answer those. So that is Legacy Infect, and I'll see you in round one. All right, here we go. So we won the die roll. Let's see what we got. No Infector, but we have a Brainstorm, we have a Fetch, we have a One Drop, we have a Daze. It's not like a 10 on the scale of completely insane Infect hands, but I think it's good enough to keep, so let's give it a shot. Keep. See how many cards our opponent keeps. Our opponent kept 7. So we're going to lead off with Noble Hierarch off of Tropical Island. That way we have Daze up in case we need to Daze something, which will be good. Green, Noble Hierarch, deployed to the battlefield. Alright, let's see what our opponent's doing. Ooh, a Mana Confluence. Alright, so probably Dredge. Yep, Dredge. Oh, I should have... That was stupid. I should have dazed that. Off to a good start. Would dazing that have been good? So... Brainstorm. So I want to go. I want to put back Forest for sure. And Wooded Foothills, I suppose. But in the other order. So Forest. On top of that, Wooded Foothills. I'm going to play Ink Moth Nexus. Add green. We'll play another Noble Hierarch. And hopefully we won't get killed this turn. We do have a Daze to protect ourselves. And if we don't get killed, we kill him next turn. So that'll be good. Oh, we're a little ways off, actually. I'm killing him. We'll have a Fetch. Yep, Putrid Imp is fine. Can't do anything about it. I'm gonna daze whatever he does, yeah. Daze. I didn't forget that time. Alright, so we need to... So we're going to play this to shuffle away Forest, which doesn't help us. Let's see, we can get 3 down here, so we're We're one mana short, it looks like. We have 3, 1 to activate, 4, 5. So we're 2 away. So hopefully we can get something in the graveyard. I will, you can't block, so I will attack with this Ink Moth Nexus. It was a 1-1 flyer. Okay, green. Beginning of combat. Anvil attack. Double exalted. All right, in for 3. So he's got 2 cards. Hopefully, play something that we could spell pierce, and that should get us pretty close. We'll get another, yeah. Hopefully, we don't get Cabal Therapied too hard. Let's see what he's got in here. He's got an Icarid, a Bridge, a Stinkweed. He got a Narco Amoeba. So I don't see any Cabal Therapies, which is pretty lucky. So I need to counter this. Alright, so Nexus into the red zone. Exalted. Exalted. That one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Into green. And Berserk. The good old-fashioned, old-school, take 18 Infect. Alright, that'll do. So, definitely should have dazed that careful study, but didn't punish us. I was talking and not paying attention to what I needed to be paying attention to, which is one of the things that's kind of interesting about recording videos is trying to talk and narrate, and sometimes you just get a little mixed up about where you're at. So try and be more careful. So let's look at the sideboard. We want crop rotation because it finds Pajuka Bog, which is great. Caracas not doing much. Viridian Corruptor, no thanks. Seal of Primordium, no thanks. Dismember, no thanks. Sylvan Library, maybe. It feels probably too slow, though. Maybe Force of Will. I don't want Submerge. I don't want Hydro Blast. I could see Fluster Storms being good because all of his spells that I need to interact with are instants and sorceries that draw cards. So what can we sideboard out? I want the Invigorates. Unsure about Force of Wills. We're on the draw, so I'll put Dazes over here as a potential to board out. Not boarding out Blighted Agent. I guess Gitaxian Probe could be something that I board out. Spell Pierce, Berserk, Crop Rotation, Glistener, Vines. Alright, Vines seems like the worst because he doesn't really interact with a lot of removal. So that would be the Crop Rotations. Now the question is, if I want Fluster Storm or Spell Pierce, is that better than anything else that I have going on? Well, I do think that Fluster Storm is probably better than Daze, especially on the draw. Although I like Daze. Maybe I don't want Probe. Maybe I just want more permission. Maybe I'll board out like a Probe for a Fluster Storm. Probe for a Fluster Storm. don't really want to pick up my lands too much, so maybe I'll board out a Daze for a Force of Will. This might not be... Oh, you know what? I'll board Wasteland out. Wasteland doesn't do anything, and I'll get another one of these cards in here. Let's go with the Flusterstorm. Okay. This might not be completely ideal. It's kind of hard for me to tell, but I think it's really close. So, I know we want more counter spells. I know we don't want dead cards. So, let's roll with this. Alright, so... We have a one drop, a pump spell, some counter spells, and a brainstorm. This looks pretty good to me. I don't know if it'll be fast enough, but I think it's good enough to have a shot, so I'm going to keep it. It's going to come down to, you know, how fast is his draw going to be? Is he going to go crazy? Am I going to get a shot to do stuff? I don't know. We'll have to find out. Our opponent conceded. Okay. Interesting. Very interesting. All right.